Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One.
That's all he wanted to do. He wanted me to come to him. He wanted me to press the fight, just like he kept going back to the ropes.
But you did that.
Huh?
That's what you did.
Yeah, yeah, but at my own pace, at my own time. When he wanted me to come, I didn't come. I came when I wanted to come.
Terrence, what's going to be next?
That's up to Bob now. He said I'm going to fight 3 times next year, so I'm looking forward to 2019. Oh man, Al Haymon and Bob to sit down and talk to each other about it. That's it. I want all of them. I'm being sanded. How bad do you want me to say something over and over and over? I said what I said, and that's it.
Daddy, my mom.
Terrence, will it be disappointing in some sense if you're fighting a woman
that
kind of like
you've been in
without
instead of?
No, not at all.
You make sure nobody does anything to him.
Man, listen. I'm willing to fight any and everybody.
Yeah, absolutely.
There is the fight. I ain't dug no red. Just like he said, he been calling me out. This the first time that I got offered to fight him. So I took the fight. You know, I don't make the fight, so I fight him.
You think anybody's gonna underestimate you ever again?
Oh man, you gonna always get that. You gonna always get that. They gonna say, oh, Benavidez wasn't nobody. He ain't fight nobody. He had a messed up leg. They gonna bring up so much stuff to say about him. To discredit me from doing what I did, just like, you know, he discredited me from fighting Jeff Horn.
Terrence, you can control what you do in the boxing ring and you have your opponent in front of you. When it comes to the stuff that goes on outside the business, you don't really have any control. So you feel like at some point it's going to be frustrating.
It gets frustrating at times because I feel like I don't get the credit I deserve. So I get a little frustrated, but at the same time, it's like you said, it's out of my hands. I can't do nothing about it, but continue to do what I do inside the ring.
You were obviously angered by the shove yesterday.
Yeah, it is.
At the way in. I mean, you left all that anger aside as soon as you came here.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct.
We'll talk for next week.
You know, once it was over, it's over. I'm focused on the fight. I'm a boxer, but I'm a puncher. But I'm a banger. I can be whatever it is. So my thing was to be as relaxed as possible coming into this fight, knowing all the built up and all the negativity things that was going on leading up to the fight, to not get missed sidetracked. Like I said, I just want the victory. The knockout come is gonna come, you know, but my main focus is getting the W. Once I get the W, then I fulfill my goal. Yeah, it's always sweeter to get the knockout, but you know, my job is to get the win.
Do you have a lot more respect for Benavidez after?
No.
Two more, and then we gotta go.
He was supposed to be the bigger, stronger guy, punch hard. As you see, every time he hit me, I laughed at him.
How'd you feel your second fight at the weight?
Oh, I felt strong. I felt strong. I already answered that question. Everybody knows.
Right. Thanks, guys.
You ever fight in Omaha?
Thank you.
Huh?
Did you bring another championship fight back to Omaha?
You know we coming back to Omaha.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Congrats.
Thank you, Joel. I believe so, but I have not seen him.